Καλησπέρα. Welcome back with this. It's been nearly 2 years since we did any concerts here. We did the first one last weekend, successfully presenting a concert of Arab music with a Palestinian singer. And we're welcoming tonight an artist that I first worked with in 1982. If any of you were around at that time, we had an organization called the Alternative Museum downtown Manhattan. And Grigoris performed with us with some other singers and some other performers. And on and off, we've worked with him over the years. So we're welcoming him back today with his group, Mikrokosmos. And tonight's concert will be about 90 minutes, no intermission. So if you want to have a drink, go get your drink and bring it to your seat. We are videotaping all this whole concert series. And after a couple of months, we'll be putting up online so that anyone that didn't get to the concert will be able to see it. So please welcome now Mikrokosmos with Grigoris Maninakis.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming. I would like to first express my thanks to all of you, but also Mr. Robert Browning for inviting us here tonight. Thank you, Robert. And I want to say a few words about the program. Of course, if we were to do an extensive presentation of Rebetika songs, the whole history, the seeds, how they started and all that, we'll probably have to dedicate a weekend maybe and meet for 3 days in a row to cover everything. But there's a lot that has been written about Rebetika by researchers and, as they call them, rebetologists. There's a lot of agreement among all these writings. There's some things that have not yet been resolved, and people have some differences as far as certain aspects of Rebetika. But very briefly, I'm going to explain how we're going to do this presentation tonight. Basically, they all agree that Rebetiko, time-wise, can be divided into maybe three major seasons, three major time intervals. They call it the classical period of Rebetiko. Those are starting with the Asia Minor disaster in 1922, when many of the refugees were the musicians from Smyrna. Smyrna was a cosmopolitan center of music. The musicians there were trained, well-trained. They were playing different instruments, different kind of music, but many of them were forced to come to Greece. So the first period of Rebetiko, classical period of Rebetiko, as they call it, is the one where those musicians are prevailing in the musical scene in Greece. That will be the first part that we're going to cover musically. We're going to present songs by composers that are rooted in Smyrna. It is interesting that period, if we were to do it exactly as they were doing it in Smyrna, we wouldn't have a bouzouki. In fact, a lot of the songs that were done by those in Smyrna by those composers were without bouzouki. And in fact, the first classical period, which is the one that those musicians are prevailing, it's called the period of Santuroviola, Santur and violin, but they didn't mention bouzouki. The second period is the 1930s, when Markos Vamvakaris is the prolific and prevailing personality in the musical scene. In that period, the 1930s, Vamvakaris and three other musicians, they had a group which was called the famous Quartet of Piraeus. In the 1930s. They created their own music and they put, I guess, their mark on that second period. That is not to say that there's no connection with the first period. In fact, all the periods are connected together because, as it turned out, all the musicians from all these periods, they worked together along this time period from the 1920s to about 1950. The third period, we have the prolific composer, the prolific personality of Vasilis Tsitsanis. He's prevailing in that period, but he's not the only one. He's the one who took Rebetiko and he moved it a step up into the, I guess, the high class society of Greece, and he gave it a lot of, or additional legitimacy. So these are the periods. The first period, the Smyrna musicians, the Vamvakaris period, the Vasilis Tsitsanis period, which of course includes other musicians as well, like Yorgos Mitsakis, Yannis Papayoannou, and others. We're going to start a little bit before the first period with almost like a sample of Smyrna-style songs. We have four songs pre-classical period, and if you have your program, you'll see it's called this Smyrna period of Rebetika. So we're starting with that, and anytime there's any kind of additional commentary, I will just put it in. But mainly, we're here to listen to the music, enjoy the music, and I hope that we have enough people who could sing along with us in many of the songs. Thank you. Σκέρτσο πεταχτώ με τα ναζάκια σου με έχεις τρελό. Σα σε βλέπω από μπροστά μου να περνάς μικρό. Μου ξετρελαίνεις φως μου το μυαλό. Σα σε βλέπω από μπροστά μου να περνάς μικρό. Μου ξετρελαίνεις φως μου το μυαλό. Σε πια να με παιδεύεις άλλο. Tell you a couple of words about the next song. It's the fourth one of the pre-classical period songs that we have selected. This one is called Tic Tac, and it kind of says Tic Tac goes my heart when I see you. Tic Tac, Tic Tac. And historically, this song is dated back somewhere between 1898 to 1901. And according to what I know, what I've read from all those people that did the research and about this, the root of those songs, there was a small record that came out at the time from Constantinople, and it said Rebetiko on it. And as far as we know, it was the first time that the word Rebetiko was used, and it was for this particular song in 1898 or maybe 1901. And one wonders, because when you hear the song, I mean, it doesn't remind you of, in any way, of the Rebetika that most people know, which, you know, a little bit heavier, a little bit, you know, and the words, you know, and all that, the lyrics. This one is like a light song, almost like a cantata. And I think, in my opinion, it kind of dispels the myth, and maybe some people have that impression that Rebetiko is like a heavy kind of song, you know, and not a light and a happy song. Listen to the song, and I think you will understand what I mean.
Σαν σε βλέπω να διαβαίνεις.
Τι κοιτά
και λόπουλί μου να μαθαίνω που πηγαίνεις.
Θέλω πουλί μου να σε ρωτήσω, φοβούμαι μη σε δυσαρεστήσω. Γιατί όταν σου μιλώ αρχίζει της καρδιάς το τικ
τικ τικ τακ.
Γιατί όταν σου μιλώ αρχίζει της καρδιάς το τικ
τικ τικ τακ.
Kind of an atmosphere, which means very informal. You know, you notice, you know, the musicians are always sitting around, you know, they're not, you know, standing up, walking around on stage. So this informal atmosphere is one of the, I think, for myself at least, one of the most attractive attributes of Rebetika. So let's make it informal in the audience. Do feel free, sing along, you know, I mean, anything you would like to do, okay? We're getting into the second period now.
Η άμαξα με στη βροχή, τράβα μαξά μη μου βραχή. Το κορίτσι που είναι μέσα, όμορφο σαν πρίγκιπεσα, μη μου βραχεί. Το στην άσφαλτο άμαξα και στρίψε πάλι στη γωνιά. Να μας πας για το τσαρδί μας, τη φωλίτσα τη δική μας, στρίψε άμαξα. Για το τσαρδί μας, τη φωλίτσα τη μικρή μας, τράβηξε ωραία μάξα.
This was a song by one of the great composers that came from Smyrna of that second period, as we call it now, Apostolos Hatzichristos, and he wrote many songs, or many, I would say, many beautiful songs. Some of the most well-known ones are Αλίτη Πίπες Μια Βραδιά, that's one of his songs, Το Παραπονιάρικο, but we're going to do something different because we want to broaden up the repertoire. So this one is a song, it's called As Μην Ξημέρωνε Ποτέ, May Dawn Never Come, because we're in love, we're together, so let dawn never come so we can stay together. Το πρωί much about Rebetika being heavy kind of songs. You know, these are like so, τόσο τρυφερές μελωδίες που θα τις ζηλεύανε πολλές εποχές. Ο Κώστας θα μας πει άλλα δύο τραγούδια του Απόστολου Χατζηχρήστου.
Thank you.
next one is a song by Kostas Skarvelis, one of those composers from that period. He came from Smyrna, he was a guitarist, great musician. And it's called Παραπονιέμαι στο Δουνιά, I grieve to the world. Into it, in the lyrics and in the music. And my friend here, Costa, said, let's make it a little bluish with a little guitar introduction at the beginning. Thank you, Costa. Now, the next song has somewhat funny lyrics. From the title of it, if you look at the program, it's called The Rusk Thief. Ipaximadoklefta. It's, well, I guess it talks about a girl that was a Paximado Kleftra, made up probably, a Rusk thief, that she got out of that condition, and now she wants to have like princes and kings. So that's kind of it's a satirical kind of a song in that mode.
Thank you.
χρόνια φυλακή τιμώρησα το χάρο. Να σε πάντα ελεύθερη μαζί σου να γουστάρω. Να σε πάντα ελεύθερη μαζί σου να γουστάρω. 50 χρόνια φυλακή τιμώρησα το χάρο.
Παναγιώτης Τούντας, great composer, γλυκιά μου Περσεφόνη. If you know anything about Παναγιώτης Τούντας and you follow now or in the past, the kind of songs he wrote, many, many of his songs refer to specific names. This one is about Περσεφόνη, there's another one about Χαρικλάκη, there's another one about Καλλιοπάκη, Ερινάκη, all female names. And I think this is one of the attractive, I guess, and interesting features of Rebetika. A lot of times they refer to real people, actually most of the time. Είναι από που λέμε στα ελληνικά, υπάρχει μια ωραία λέξη ελληνική, βιωματικό τραγούδι. Αναφέρεται σε καταστάσεις και σε θέματα που είναι της προσωπικής εμπειρίας του καθενός. Και αυτό νομίζω είναι αυτό που κάνει το Rebetiko να έχει κρατήσει τόσα πολλά χρόνια. So many years. I don't think there's any other kind of song that is sung today and it was sung 40, 50, 100 years back. And this is, I think, the value of the kind of songs that Rebetiko are. Persephone.
Μια καμώμα του κι ωραία
right along. Markos Vamvakaris, the 1930s, prolific personality, the grandfather of Rebetiko. I know most of you, or many of you, know about Vamvakaris because he's so well known now. But you know, he was never a musician when he started. Actually, he came from Syros, and initially his first profession was a butcher. And he didn't like it. He didn't like the job. And one time, he says in his biography that he was going around and he saw somebody playing a bouzouki, and he liked that. He was a young man, and he said, "I'm going to learn this instrument, and if I don't learn it within a few months, I'm going to cut my arm with a balta of the hasapi, of the butcher." Well, he learned it, and he learned it very well. At 3 a.m., I'm going to come and wake you up. Now, Vamvakaris wrote many, many songs, and in most of them, or in a lot of them, he wrote the lyrics as well. And he was very, very harsh when he was writing songs about women. Maybe some women in his life that didn't respond to him or that they gave him trouble, but he was very, very harsh in the lyrics of those songs. We're not going to do one of those. We're going to do a nice one that's very, very πολύ τρυφερό. But I want to tell you some of the words that he uses. There's a song that he wrote, and it's called Ο Ηρακλής. I'll say it in Greek first, and then I'll translate as well as I can. Ήθελα να μου Ηρακλής, όταν σε πρωτοείδα, να σου κόβα την κεφαλή σαν τη Λερναία Ήδρα. I mean, and there's another one that my wife hates. And I have it recorded somewhere. But it says, seriously though, I cannot think of anything harsher for a man to say to a woman than this song. I'm going to tell you the words in Greek and then translate again. Δεν σε θέλω πια, δεν είσαι ωραία, γέρασες και πια δεν σ' αγαπώ. Αγάπησα καλύτερη και νέα και με τα γνάτι στα φιλιά βραδιές μεθώ. I mean, really, seriously now, I can't think of anything worse, anything harsher that can be told a woman by her husband or her man. Should I translate? I don't want you anymore because you've gotten old and I don't love you anymore. And I fell in love with somebody who's much younger than you, and with her kisses I get drunk at nights. But this one is on the other side. On the other hand, he wrote some very, very tender songs. This one is one of them. Like the other one that everybody knows, τα ματόκλαδά σου λάμπουν σαν τα λούλουδα του κάμπου. I mean, that's pretty, you know, so. But this one is really, this one is my favorite.
Thank you.
this. How do you translate mangas?
Mangas.
How do you translate mangas in English? Some words cannot be translated.
Machos.
Nothing to do with manga, huh? Vavagiakis and three other musicians, they made up this wonderful team of musicians doing Rebetika at that time, and it was called the famous Quartet of Pereas. Vavagiakis was one of them, Yorgos Batis was the other one, Anesis Delias was the third one, and Stratos Pagiomtzis was the fourth member of that team. Anesis Delias was the guitarist of the group, and he died when he was 34 or 35 years old because of a drug overdose. The history goes that he had a girlfriend that he wasn't into drugs, but his girlfriend was, and at night he kind of put something in his nose and he got used to it, and he died in the streets. Anestis Delias. Stratos Pagiomtzis is one of the greatest singers of all time in Greece. They thought that his voice was operatic. It was an operatic range. And George Zabetas, at one time in his autobiography, said, after Stratos Pagiomtzis and Stelios Kazantzidis, two great voices, chaos. The chaos.
Yes.
He really believed in Stratos Pagiomtzis' voice. This particular song is by Yorgos Batis, and it's a song about work. The Rebetika songs had a lot of themes: love, poverty, dismay, work. This one is about work, about the work of a stalker, or thermastis.
Γεια σου, Γρηγόρη.
Your jealous eyes have made me crazy. The 1940s, Vasilis Tsitsanis, of course, is the prevailing personality of those of that period, not only of that period, because Vasilis Tsitsanis continued, and actually he's the one who has elevated rebetiko from the ghetto that was originally στα Σαλόνια, to the high class people in Greece. Of course, we must say something about Manos Katsidakis here, because, you know, the first two periods of rebetiko, it was not really very well respected at the high levels of society in Greece. In 1948, in one of the theaters of Athens, Manos Katsidakis was t- 24 years old then, he made his famous lecture about Rebetiko. And in very few, he brought Vavakaris and Papayoannou and I believe Soteria Bellou in the theater just to demonstrate what he was going to talk about in his lecture. And he made the point that Rebetiko is the foundation of Greek music. And he says, whatever we play now, myself and the other trained musicians, they owe it to Rebetiko because Rebetiko is in the heart of Greek music. Now, that didn't go well with the high society of Athens. They didn't like that because they thought Rebetiko was only for, you know, lower class people and for the ghetto. And I don't know if you know this, but at that time, the police went to Hatzidakis' house and told his mother, keep him away for a while because his life is in danger. He was threatened, or some people threatened that they're going to do harm to him because he said these things about the Rebetiko. Something has happened also here for other reasons, right? Yeah. Συνεπιασμένη Κυριακή.
Thank you.
ωραίατατη. Now, this one is another song by Vasilis Tsitsanis, of course, and it's called Όταν στα κέντρα σε πηγαίνω, When I Take You Out of the Nightclubs. And it's a kind of a threat or a warning. When I take you out of the nightclubs and people around, they look at you, don't dare do something that is going to embarrass me.
Γιατί να ξέρεις πως θα παραξηγηθείς. Να μην τολμήσεις να προσέξεις, μην τυχόν παρεκτραπείς. Γιατί να ξέρεις πως θα παραξηγηθείς.
What happened to you? You're making a lot of mistakes. This is the next song. Τι έχεις πάθει, πέφτεις σε λάθη. Και κάθε μέρα βρίζεις και γελάς. Βασίλης Τσιτσάνης. Thank you. next song is of the period. It was written actually in 1946, and it is by George Mitsakis. It's one of the songs that I discovered only a few months ago. It was not one of the most well-known one by Yorgos Mitsakis, but I liked it so much that I thought we would actually put it in this program and also put it on a CD that I recorded last summer in Greece. I was tempted to try to translate the words literally of that song, but you know, if I translate the words literally, it wouldn't make any sense in English. So I'm only gonna say basically what the song talks about. I mean, let me give you an example. Those of you who speak Greek would understand. At some point in the third verse, the song says, "Θα αλλάξω το βιολί." I will change the violin. But you know, we all know what it means in Greek, but it doesn't mean anything in English. Because basically the song is a man talking to a woman, and basically he says, "There will be a time where I will leave you. Because the way you treat me like a piece of dirt. So there will be a point where when I will leave you." Now, θα αλλάξω το βιολί, I will change the violin. In Greek, it's an idiom that means I will change my ways, I will change my character, and in this case, the changing will be that I'll get rid of you and I will leave you. So otherwise, from the, you know, besides the lyrics, the song is, for me, is a very beautiful song, and I'd like to present it to you.
Thank you.
say a couple of words about the next song too. The next song is a fairly well-known song, Για την απονιά σου, for your lack of compassion, I guess, if I translate it. But you know, in 1975, George Dallaras came out with a record that was called 50 Years of Rebetiko. And that, for me, was like the point where I really started to listen to Rebetika, and I loved it. I mean, this record must have listened to it, you know, hundreds of times. And there was one song in it, this particular song, Για την απονιά σου, was in that record. And I always thought, I didn't search it out to see the origin of that song, I thought it was always a rebetiko by someone, and that's why Dallaras included it in that record. Later on, when I got involved with music and I started searching out where the songs came from, etc., etc., I realized that this song is by Nikos Gunaris. And for some reason, it was recorded in that 50 Years of Rebetiko by George Dallaras. It's still a question in my mind, and I've asked several people, they just don't have an answer, or there's no answer. And they said it was a nice song, so he put it there. Thank you. next song is from the 1940s because it refers to perhaps the, what, how should I characterize it? One of the most world-changing events during World War II. It was the bomb that was dropped in Japan. And what amazed me about this song was the fact that the Rebetas at the time, in their poverty, you know, it was during the war, Ipina, hunger, and all that, they had this, the political, even the political sensitivity to come up with a song that in five verses described almost like the whole World War II. Even if you don't understand Greek, at some point in the song, you will hear names like Hitler, Mussolini, and Hirohito blended into the lyrics of the song. So let's listen to it. Μέσα στην Αμερική νέα βόμβα έχει βγει, πέφτει μια στη Ιαπωνία, χάλασε όλη η κοινωνία. Πέφτει μια στη Ιαπωνία, χάλασε όλη η κοινωνία. Τρόμαξε όλη η Ιαπωνιά, ανερίχνανε και τρίτη, όρθιο δε θα ήταν σπίτι. Ανερίχνανε και τρίτη, όρθιο δε θα ήταν σπίτι. Going to again one more time dispel the myth that Rebetika is our heavy songs talking only about, you know, subjects like hashish and things that are not as soft and as what word should I use? Well, let me tell you about the song Dominoret Sabyis, one of the most The Minor of the Dawn was written by Spiros Peristeris, one of the Smyrna-rooted composers, and it is considered a rebetiko. So let's all end the show with that beautiful song, and I hope I'm going to encourage every one of you to join in. Ο Στίβ Βαβαγιάκης στα χρουστά, ο Άγγελος Παπαδάτος στον μπάσο, ο Κώστας Μπαλταζάνης στη γιθάρα, ο Κώστας Ψαρός μπουζούκι τζουρά και πολιτικά, ο Μαυροδής Κοντάνης ούτι, βιολί, τραγούδι, Baglama. Η Μέγαν Γκούλντ, βιολί, Baglama και ούτι. Thank you so much. We have some CDs if you'd like to listen to some of the songs that were recorded. We're going to do a song that was created here in America. It's a song of the early 1930s, and it's called The West, The West. It's like a journey through some of the Western states where the Greeks were at the, you know, in the early 1920s. And this one is about some of the Greeks that were kind of got into some of the dice games and card games, and they lost all their money. In the song, you will hear some of the Gringlish words. You're going to hear like Sacramento, San Francisco, Lodi, Butte, Montana, Salt Lake City, Soleki. Also, some words like, at some point, he says, I went there, I tried to take a chance, and I was left with no sense. They took everything up to a sense. He's going to say, Πήγα για να πάρω chance, δεν μ' αφήκαν ούτε sense. So, recorded at that time, but in 1994, a group of Greek American musicians, I was one of them, we took all those songs from the first Greek immigrants in the United States, and we made a record that we called Cafe Aman America, and we very purposely selected all the songs that had as many Gringlish words in them as possible. One of the most famous one that made the charts at the time. It was done in 1994, and in 1997 was presented in Greece at the Likavitos Theater, and some of the, then we went to Europe for a tour. One of the most famous songs was Γιατί γλυκό μου sweetheart να με πληγώνεις τόσο hard. Now, we're not gonna do that, but we're gonna do The West, but that was another very Gringlish song that was included in that record, Cafe Aman America. So here's The West. Thank you.
έτσι δεν μ' αφήκαν ούτε σέντσι.
Thank you very much.